Perhaps you've had an ultrasound scan or another scan and you've been told you have a liver cyst and now you're curious. That has led you to this video. Whatever the reason, you are in the right place. But what is a liver cyst? A cyst is a sac full of fluid that has a lining such as shown over here in this cartoon of the liver. As you can imagine, if these are large enough, they are a bit like a balloon inside the tummy, causing symptoms of fullness, difficulty in bending over. They are important because certain types of cysts do require treatment, and there are of course many different types. In this talk I shall focus later on the biliary cyst adenoma, because this particular type has malignant potential. What are the types of cysts? The commonest are the simple cysts or the solitary cysts. As the name implies, they are thin-walled cysts within the liver. They occur widely within the population and are routinely picked up on scans, and the great majority do not require any treatment at all. It is only when they get beyond a certain size and start causing symptoms is treatment may be contemplated. I have done a full video on this, which is linked. Polycystic is a variant of genetic origin, and there are many cysts within the liver. Yet again, this is linked through a different video. Hydatid cyst is common in sheep-rearing parts of the world due to infestation. More details in a separate video. Cyst adenoma is a particular kind of cyst that will be detailed later. Cysts may also be due to cancers that have spread to the liver from other parts. There are several other less common causes of the cysts and rare causes which have been outlined over here for specialist interest only. A brief description of the biliary cyst adenoma, or the mucinous cystic neoplasm of the liver, which is a rare cause for a cyst, more common in the females. So what is it? In the cartoon over here, in this corner, you can see a thicker walled cyst, and it may have finger-like projections with a thicker, more viscous fluid, and it has septations. These features, when seen on imaging, are concerning for biliary cyst adenoma, or MCN, mucinous cystic neoplasm. Why is it important? It is important because 15% of these cysts may turn malignant over the lifetime of a person. The great majority do not cause symptoms. However, if of large enough size, they can cause pain, fullness, early filling after a meal, tiredness, and rarely, if malignant transformation happens, then you may have features of malignancy, such as increased pain, weight loss, and loss of appetite, and less commonly jaundice or other complications. How do we diagnose a biliary cyst adenoma? And that is done through scans, such as over here you can see an ultrasound scan showing features of a cyst in the liver with thick walls and projections, as seen over here. A CT scan confirms the same diagnosis. These features are concerning for biliary cyst adenoma. So once diagnosed, the treatment involves removal by way of surgery. And removal has to be complete, because if any part of the cyst is left behind, that is at risk of developing cancer. The surgery for this can be performed through minimally invasive or the open root. The aim is to completely remove the cyst, as mentioned before, and this can be done either through just removing the cyst, or sometimes it's inevitable to remove part of the liver where the cyst is contained. Other treatments, such as aspiration or just removing part of the cyst, are not effective. This completes a brief overview of biliary cyst adenoma. I hope you found the video of use. If you have any comments, please do share.